the 4th of September 2017. Manager of Republic of Ireland Martin O'Neill during a press conference at FAI NTC in Abbotstown, Dublin. Photo by David Maher, SportsfileA. A defiant Martin O'Neill has warned people not to write off the Republic of Ireland's World Cup qualification hopes as they target a crucial victory over Serbia. The Republic returned from Georgia during the early hours of Sunday morning facing strong criticism of their display in a 1-1 draw in Tbilisi, with O'Neill himself admitting their first half performance was as poor 45 minutes as they have produced during the campaign to date. Watch. Martin O'Neill disappointed with Republic of Ireland performance. Sky Sports. Replay video up next. Benitez hails Newcastle spiritRafa. Benitez says, Newcastle have defended and attacked extremely well throughout the whole season so far following their 2-0 win at Leeds. Sky Sports. Coleman on Rooney and curfewsWales manager Chris Coleman has defended England captain Wayne Rooney and has explained how he deals with player curfews on international duty. Sky Sports. Tyler's teaser 22nd November. Martin Tyler brings you his latest teaser from Old Trafford ahead of Manchester United's game with Arsenal. Sky Sports. One cancel. SETTINGSOFFHDHQSDLO. What to watch. Next, Benitez hails Newcastle spirit. Sky Sports 1. 51 Coleman on Rooney and curfews. Sky Sports 3. 16 Tyler's teaser the 22nd of November. Sky Sports 1. 23 Cammy praises Zachary Bonilla. Sky Sports 0. 28 What next for Gerrard and Lampard? Sky Sports 2. 58 Should Wenger have risked Sanchez? Sky Sports 2. 26 Match in a minute, Watford 2-1 Leicester. Sky Sports 1. 05 Montanier praises Forest efficiency. Sky Sports 2. 48 Best of Soccer Saturday the 19th of November. Sky Sports 5. 46 Match in a minute, Southampton 0-0 Liverpool. Sky Sports 1. 10 Match in a minute, Sunderland 3-0 Hull. Sky Sports 0. 51 Crystal Palace 1-2 Man City, Guardiola. Sky Sports 2. 56 Sunderland 3-0 Hull, Phelan. Sky Sports 2. 25 Crystal Palace 1-2 Man City, Pardew. Sky Sports 2. 42 Watford 2-1 Leicester, Mazzari. Sky Sports 3. 09 Watford 2-1 Leicester, Ranieri. Sky Sports 2. 16 Up next Tuesday night's clash with Serbia, who lead Group D by 2 points thanks to their 3-0 win over Moldova the same night, has looked likely to be pivotal for some time. But with Wales now breathing down Ireland's neck, it has assumed even greater importance. But O'Neill remains unbowed as he attempts to guide a team seated fourth in the group when the draw was made to a top two finish. He said, we were in a tough group and we were fourth seeds. So there was Wales, Austria and Serbia in front of us. What we're going to try and do is remember that it's been difficult from the start. That's number one. If we can't win the group, then we're going to try to get into the playoffs. That will mean we've finished in front of teams who were rated ahead of us. You have asked why they're rated in front of us in the last couple of years. Maybe their records are better. Maybe their coefficients are better over a certain period of time. I don't know. Wales's efforts at the Euros were very commendable. In fact, they were excellent. We are in there fighting. That's what we're doing. We are unbeaten in the group at this moment. It's hard to believe, but we're unbeaten in the group. We're going to try and do two things, win the game. And if we can't do that, then we'll try to get something out of it. But first and foremost, we're going to try and win the match. If we win, then we set ourselves up for a grandstand finish. Ireland have produced big performances when they have needed them during O'Neill's near four-year reign, no more so than the night they beat world champions Germany 1-0 in Dublin to help secure a Euro 2016 playoff place in which they hit the heights once again to beat Bosnia-Herzegovina 2-0 at the Aviva. Shane Long in action for the Republic of Ireland. The manager will have no qualms about calling upon that spirit once again, knowing that his team is often at its best when up against it. He said, "That's exactly what we can do. Think of the nights we've had here at the Aviva. Splendid evenings. You mentioned Germany, the world champions, we beat them. The playoff game against Bosnia was fantastic. The fight backs in some of the other matches that we've had and the grandstand finishes. All of those things should be uppermost in our minds." That was a theme taken up by striker Jonathan Walters, whose double against Bosnia booked the Republic's trip to France. He said, "We have sat here after the last couple of games and we've said it's never going to be plain sailing in the group. We're not one of the top teams in Europe, like Spain, Italy, Germany, France. We're not going to run away with the group, but we're always going to be competitive and be in there. It was a disappointing result in Georgia, but there was always going to be the same mentality to go into the Serbia game to get the 3 points and to win the game. We can draw on past results we've had at the Aviva and hopefully give it full throttle and go for it. We have been without top quality players throughout the campaign at different stages. We have Seamus Coleman recovering from a broken leg, and we can cope all the time. It does not matter if they are stronger or not. We have a game on our hands. We will try and do our utmost to win. We are not the most talented outfit, but we have great spirit and I am sure that will help us tomorrow night." However, O'Neill has had to admit defeat in his efforts to have key midfielder Jeff Hendrick available after he was ruled out having undergone a scan on a lingering thigh injury. He also has concerns around two of his more creative players, Wes Houlihan and Aidan Majidi, who have groin and hamstring injuries respectively.